Hello and welcome to another video, my name is Kemal AA, and this is a review for the Chelsea versus Newcastle game, which ended 2-0 to Chelsea as we won and we got another 3 points. And for me, it's a fantastic victory when it, you know, in regards to the result, away at Newcastle, where, you know, often historically we struggle at, you know, only one win since 2011 at St James' Park. We got the 3 points and we got another clean sheet as well. You know, 7 clean sheets in our past 8 games. Tremendous record, tremendous stuff, really gives that defence a massive confidence, and we did it without, you know, our best centre back Thiago Silva, our leader, so we coped very well. However, there are some negatives. You know, we were very wasteful in front of goal, we weren't clinical whatsoever, very wasteful, and I'll be getting delving into tactics, the analysis, and giving my thoughts, opinions. But I'm relieved, honestly, that we got the 3 points. That was the main job, main objective, and we got the 3 points. But before I do get into it, make sure you smash the like button, subscribe, hit the bell notification, and comment down on your thoughts screens in the comment section below, and give me your man of match as well. Now, getting into the game, now starting off with the lineup, I thought Lampard had the tactics spot on. I thought he had the formation spot on, you know, in regards to injuries and, you know, COVID, etc. Of course, Kai Havertz, he has recovered from COVID. However, of course, he hasn't had any match fitness in the past 2 weeks, so he needs to regain the match fitness. You also had Pulisic, who's still currently injured. You know, he's still 1 or 2 weeks away from returning to full fitness, meaning Tammy Abraham got the nod on. And it was pretty much the identical team that played against Sheffield United, where we won 4-1. So for me, there was no need to change the team whatsoever. Lampard did exactly that, and the tactics were spot on in my personal opinion. I think that the way that we had the 4-3-3 with the two attacking eights deployed, you know, we had Mason Mount and Kovacic, the two attacking eights. Kovacic transitioning and playing in midfield. You had Kante as your number six, your athletic DM, you know, winning the ball, sweeping up in front of the back four. And of course, we had Rudiger and Zuma. I would have preferred Christensen instead of Rudiger, but again, I thought Rudiger was quite decent, would give him some confidence, and he got the clean sheet. And of course, the normal fullbacks of Reece James and Chilwell, you know, our world-class fullbacks on form, currently the best in the world. And Edouard Mendy in goal. Tammy up front, shifting Timo Werner on the left wing, Hakim Ziyech, our magician, on the right hand side, and very solid team. Tactics wise, was good. You know, the way the Kovacic was operating in between the lines, he had a lot of freedom, a lot of pockets of space operating, transitioning the play, transitioning from defence to attack. You had Mason Mount as well, who I thought was really, really good in his normal natural number 8 position. That's his best position, moving the ball quickly, his shooting, his passing range on point, his pace, agility, his decision making. I was really impressed with Mason Mount today. And yeah, overall it was a good performance. I just think, if you look this, I'll put it into perspective. Before, prior to the game, if you offered me a 2-0 victory away at St James's Park in Newcastle, I would have slapped your hand off. But because of how the game panned out and, you know, the scenario and everything, I am slightly underwhelmed. Now, that is kind of spoiled of me to say, considering our historical record, but I am very underwhelmed because we should have won about 5 or 6-0. And I'm not even exaggerating when I state that. Timo Werner missed 2 golden opportunities. Timo Werner scored an offside goal towards the end, and he missed 2 sitters. One in the first half, beautiful link-up play of Tammy Abraham, putting him through. It was literally a sitter, 1v1. He puts it just wide, unlucky. A bad day at the office for him. And then with the second opportunity, again, he really should be scoring. Again, he missed 2 sitters, but he had a beautiful assist for Tammy Abraham, who made it 2-0. A fantastic run through the middle, carved them open like butter through a knife. Two men weaved his way through with pace, agility, this pace, acceleration, turbo Timo, exactly. Puts Tammy through, Tammy makes it 2-0, doubles our lead, 3 points, thank you very much. Back down to London. That's exactly what happens. But again, Timo Werner really should have been on the score sheet tonight. He really, really should have been on the score sheet this lunchtime. Really, really surprised he wasn't, you know, with his record, his clinical record, his calibre level. I'm really surprised he didn't. And, you know, like I said, scoring an offside goal, really unlucky, but it wasn't his day. Still got the assist. But we know with his elite mentality and his elite goal scoring record that Timo Werner will return next game and he will be scoring. So, you know, it does happen. He's been really good for us so far this season since we signed him. And yes, it could happen. Hakim Ziyech as well was really unlucky not to get an assist today. Again, beautiful balls put in, especially for that in the first half. The ball he put in for Tammy Abraham, that in-swinging left, that in-swinging ball with his left foot. Beautiful, man. His left foot is one of a kind. Yes, it wasn't as great as Sheffield, but he's still good. You know, he's making things happen. You could see the sharpness that he brings, the creativity, you know, the movement, the passing, the pace, the agility, his decision-making is on point. You know, he's simply a world-class player. There's nothing more to say on him. Again, Tammy Abraham, he was awarded man of match by BT Sport, but who do you think is man of match now? For me, I wouldn't give it to Tammy Abraham, despite him scoring the second goal. I think that, yes, his in-cup play was pretty good, but I think I would be giving the man of match to Hakim Ziyech. I thought that he was superb. I know it wasn't, he didn't get an assist or score, but his creativity, you know, his creativity, making things happen, moving the ball, drifting into the half space, into right hand side in the pockets of space, you know, his link up play, his, you know, his breaking of the lines was really good. And same with Mason Mount, you know, Mason Mount's for a shout for man of the match, his breaking of the lines, N'Golo Kanté in that deep lying playmaking position, number six, winning the ball back, his diagonal balls as well was on point, winning the ball back. Like I said, Kanté on the ball was really impressive today, really, really impressive. And in the game where you play against Newcastle, where, you know, you don't exactly going to have a lot of possession, you're going to have a lot of the ball, you need a more of a deep line playmaker, and Kanté, he's going to have a lot of the ball, but he utilised the ball correctly, and I was really impressed with that. So for me, yes, Kanté is a very technical player, and I think that, yes, for the system, it does work. But the only question is with the system is, if N'Golo Kanté does get injured, what happens? Who plays? You know, does Jorginho play? But Jorginho doesn't really fit the system because he hasn't got the athleticism to recover the ball enough, despite him being really good defensively in the past. That's hence why Frank Lampard is looking at players such as Declan Rice. Now, defensively, we kept a clean sheet. Again, a massive bonus. Really good for the confidence boost. It also meant Thiago Silva got a fantastic rest. He was rested because, of course, he only flew in yesterday from Brazil. You know, he's 36 years of age. He needs his rest. So that was fine. Really good came in. Like I said, I would have preferred Tomori or Christensen. But really good done the job, so impressed, you know, kudos to him. Zouma again, solid, winning all his aerial duels, his passing, his link-up play, Reece James, his crossing ability, unlucky not to get an assist from him, but again, you know, an absolute tank. You know, when it came to the defensive side of things, sly tackling, winning the ball back, his physical presence, you know, he's so strong, bullying Alan Saint-Maximin, you know, had him in his pocket all game. And Newcastle really wasn't that good today. You know, I was really happy, you know, don't get me wrong, I don't want them to be good. But they were really poor today, you know, offensively. They didn't really test Mendy. You know, Carroll had that chance towards the end. But I don't really recall Mendy having too much to do. You know, Mendy's distribution was on point, was underrated in my opinion. I know Newcastle were missing Ryan Fraser and Callum Wilson. But still, you know, offensively, they really struggled, which is good for us. But that is due to us as well. You know, we nullified that threat offensively. We kept him at bay, you know, with the possession, with the moving off the ball. And I think Frank Lampard should really be impressed and pleased with the overall performance. You know, clean sheet. 2-0 victory away from home, a place that we, you know, we genuinely struggle at historically. We got the 3 points. We are top of the league temporarily, you know, joint with Leicester, top of the table on goal difference. But of course, things are going to change when Leicester, Spurs and Liverpool play. But again, you know, we really got a fighting chance this season. When I said that Chelsea were dark horses a few weeks ago, I really meant it. I think that a lot of teams are really not, you know, giving Chelsea the rating they deserve, but that's fine. You know, that's how Chelsea operate. We like to operate under the radar, where, you know, we don't get a lot of light on us. You know, we always do well when we're the underdog. So, you know, we're ticking along nicely. We're ticking along slowly, you know, playing well, performing well. And like I said, you know, really impressive team performance. Top solid performances. Callum coming on, giving that bright spark. And don't forget, we saw Kai Havertz and Christian Pulisic to come as well. So a lot of things to look forward to. Genuinely a lot of things to look forward to. And the depth we have as well. Jorginho off the bench. Callum Hudson-Odoi. You know, Havertz, Pulisic. Aspilicueta off the bench. You know, Thiago Silva didn't even feature today. Like, the amount of quality and squad depth we have. We generally have enough depth and quality to compete on all fronts. I know we're already out the League Cup, but we've got enough quality for the FA Cup, Premier League, Champions League. So it's really all to play for. Really impressed with the performance. But what do you guys think? Leave me your thoughts in the comment section below. If you did enjoy this review, don't forget to smash like, button, subscribe, hit the bell notification. And I will see you guys for the next video. Peace.